David's cameraman for me today. Say hi, David. Yeah, I can see that. He waved, by the way. We've had a few questions on how we get the fat chocobo, because a lot of people were amazed that it went to Frankfurt and back. So we've had a lot of people ask, A, how the costume works, how it goes together, and how we travel with it, given that we don't have a car. So all this goes on trains and public transport. We managed to get this on an aeroplane, although not in this format. That was a colossal pain in the backside. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you that, so this is the two parts that sort of comes in. That I usually just carry on my shoulder on a train to Expo, and David usually has to sort of wheel the box. So what I will do is I'll get it all unwrapped and we'll show you how it goes together. Right, so as you can see, I've got it all out of its cellophane, took about 10 minutes. So I can run you through the components. Obviously we've got a Gasal Green, because what fat chocobo doesn't have a Gasal Green? We also have a Mohawk, which we use to turn it into the Yu-Gi-Oh! Nuratori. Also not required for fat chocobo. So we've got the saddle, which is just fabric and cardboard with a few embellishments on, which just Velcro's on when he's built. We've got the awesome plushy feet, quite probably one of my favourite things I've actually built so far. So I'll show you how to put those on with the costume. We've got the head, obviously. We've got the body. Now the body comes apart in two pieces because, as mentioned when getting it to Frankfurt, we actually had to pack it that way around and squash the whole thing in order to get it into the aeroplane luggage regulations. And that just attaches back onto the body with three zips. People have often asked me, how do the wings work? In all honesty, it's just a pulley system on a bar. Likewise with the head, the beak works in exactly the same way. We've got one harness that goes on the body, a second hard belt that goes round to support the body. Again, I will show those all in a minute. The tail is flat packed. And basically all that happens is that pivots up, and I've got these screws on here which will hold that up, which then builds the tail up so that when you've got it up, the tail is all at the right angle. So I'm going to put that together, and I'm not going to have you endure me fiddling for 15 minutes trying to get these zips aligned, so we will do a cut here. Hello again. By the magic of studio editing, we have spared you the hilarity of me fiddling with trying to align three zips and fiddling with the screws, most often losing half the nuts and bolts like we do at Expo, usually having to put it together with gaffer tape at the last minute. So as you can see, I now have the harnesses on. So this is the one that simply just sits on the hip and takes the weight for the front of the outfit. And this is the harness with a piece at the back which attaches to the back of the neck of the costume, which essentially takes the rest of the weight. If you're wearing this costume for several hours, the weight is literally all there. It absolutely agony the next day, but all in the name of cosplay. So right, I'm going to climb on in to the rather ungracious entrance of the chocobo's rear end. So that simply lifts up and over. Please do excuse George in the background. Every time we get chocobos out and things like that, it's because we're going out somewhere, which he does not like. So the first step, once you're sort of in and holding the costume, is to put your feet through the leg holes, like so, and zip up your exit. Excuse me, disappearing. And also the tail plate that I showed you earlier has a belt on it just to go around your waist, and that takes the weight of the tail and puts it at the right angle. Next, you have to wiggle the sticks up, and there's some Velcro underneath the neck piece to take the weight there, and as mentioned, the tag on the back. Which then hooks
onto the back to take the weight. So the whole thing is now suspended, meaning that I can freely wiggle the wings using the bar and wiggle them independently. So now we need help to put the feet on. You can put this outfit on solo. It is extremely difficult. I had to do it at Frankfurt as Ellie wasn't allowed backstage for the cosplay contest. That was difficult. It mostly involved me sitting on the floor and quivering lots, much to the hilarity of the other cosplay entrants wondering what on earth is going on in here. Incoming George. Originally the leg pieces were going to go on with sort of a belt and some clips to go on, but unfortunately I never got around to doing that in time, so they do just safety pin to my trousers currently. So that's the main body on. There is one other element that I forgot to mention previously, which is just a face cloth, which basically goes on and hides my ugly mug from view, which makes for better photos, I think, personally. So, there's not a huge amount of room to move in here. So, Ellie, if you wouldn't mind sticking on my saddle. Again, you can sort of build all this in advance and just sort of carefully wiggle your way into the whole thing. Be nice, George. Right, well, I've managed to get the face cloth tangled up, so never mind. Right, and we're ready for the head, are we?
Yeah, I think so.
Which means I need to evict the parrot. Georgie, if you wouldn't mind going and flying away, please.
Good boy.
Right, so then, to complete the transformation, one head. Which just aligns with Velcro. And then you have a preener that goes around and adjusts all your feathers.
Sorry about this. I'm going to intervene for Hand myself while I'm recording. Sorry, if I could just show everyone this. It's the feathers underneath the beak that I've got to worry about to create the seamless look. That's more like it. There you go. Right.
And that just hides all the seams then. All right, and then that's it, I believe. That's the...
Sorry, all interactive for cinematography from the cameraman.
Into a chocobo.
Donna, can you flex the beak for me, please? Thank you.
Again, that's just
each wing. No on the other side, please. And okay, and the one far side. Note, everyone, they are independently operating. Oh, and we have a visit from the chocobo again.
Well, definitely can't say goodbye before without having a chocobo. So
we have a chocobo and a chocobo.
So from the three of us, or the four of us, hello and bye bye.
Thank you all.
Are you dancing? The original inspiration for the chocobo. Yes, you are. You show us pretty wings. Show us those pretty wings. Pretty wings. Of course, I can't do the gesture from in there. Pretty wings. That was really lazy.